The only problem I have is with the second clause of the last sentence in the first paragraph, but changes in the magnitude well short of catastrophic. I think that this statement may be too reassuring. It is distinctly possible that the CPP scenario will later produce effects which will indeed be catastrophic, at least for a substantial fraction of the Earth's population. I would feel more comfortable if the first paragraph concluded with the statement to the effect that future developments in global data gathering analysis, along with advances in climate modeling, may provide strong evidence for the CO2 effect of a truly substantial magnitude. The temperature rise is predicted to be distributed non-uniformly over the Earth, with above average temperature elevations in the polar regions and relatively small increases in the equator. There is unanimous agreement in the scientific community that a temperature increase of this magnitude will be about significant changes in the Earth's climate, including mineral distribution and alterations in the biosphere. The time required for pulling the atmospheric CO2 depends on future world consumption of fossil fuels. The only problem is with the second clause of the last sentence in the first paragraph. But changes of the magnitude are short of catastrophic. I think the statement may be reassuring. It is distinctly possible that the CPP scenario will later produce effects which will indeed be catastrophic, at least for a substantial fraction of the Earth's population. I would feel more comfortable if the full paragraph included with the statement the effect that future developments in global data during the analysis, along with indices in climate modeling, may provide strong evidence for the CO2 of a truly substantial magnitude. The temperature has its predicted to distribute non-uniformly over the Earth, with the largest temperature elevated in the polar regions and analysis in small cases in the air. The advantage is due to the scientific community that its temperature rates of this magnitude would be about significant changes in its climate, permitting rainfall and changes in all the birds in the biosphere. The only time I have is with the second clause between the sentence and the first paragraph, possible changes in the magnitude well short of catastrophic. I think that this statement may be too reassuring. It is distinctly possible that the CPP scenario will later produce effects which will indeed be catastrophic, at least for a substantial fraction of the Earth's population. I would feel more comfortable if the first paragraph concluded with the statement to the effect that future developments in global data gathering analysis, along with advances in climate modeling, may provide strong evidence for the CO2 effect of a truly substantial magnitude. The temperature rise is predicted to be distributed non-uniformly over the Earth, with above average temperature elevations in the polar regions and relatively small increases in the equator. There is unanimous agreement in the scientific community that a temperature increase of this magnitude will be about significant changes in the Earth's climate, including mineral distribution and alterations in the biosphere. The time required for pulling the atmospheric CO2 depends on future world consumption of fossil fuels. The only problem is with the second clause of the last sentence in the first paragraph. But changes of the magnitude are short of catastrophic. I think the statement may be reassuring. It is distinctly possible that the CPP scenario will later produce effects which will indeed be catastrophic, at least for a substantial fraction of the Earth's population. I would feel more comfortable if the full paragraph included with the statement the effect that future developments in global data during the analysis, along with indices in climate modeling, may provide strong evidence for the CO2 of a truly substantial magnitude. The temperature has its predicted to distribute non-uniformly over the Earth, with the largest temperature elevated in the polar regions and analysis in small cases in the air. The advantage is due to the scientific community that its temperature rates of this magnitude would be about significant changes in its climate, permitting rainfall and changes.